Since the birth, Earth has gone through at least 5 ice ages. And in the last ice age, the only Homo sapiens survived, and other like us went extinct. But now, be ready, because another ice age is about to begin. I mean, in just imagine scenario. So what could you do to survive on a frozen planet? How would a new ice age change the shape of Earth? Or can we stop this ice age before it froze everything? Well, just imagine if we entered in a new ice age. During an ice age in Earth's history, global temperature dropped well below freezing across the planet. And it was not icy trips around the sun. Earth can take hundreds of millions of years to thaw out. The most recent ice age started around 2.6 million years ago. Ice ages have power to change our planet. They reshape landscapes, they create new lakes and rivers. Plants and animals cling to life, either adapting or facing extinction. So if a new ice age begin today, how would we be able to make it through? Our sixth major ice age would be a few thousand years in the making, and it would begin with Earth's tilt on its axis, going through its cycle of changes. An unstable tilt plus a little wobble in our orbit around the sun, and there would be less solar radiations reaching the planet. You would see the first side effect of this on the northern hemisphere. Each year, the once lovely summer temperature would start to drop. Eventually, they would fail to rise above freezing, and that's when the snowfall would begin to build up. Over time, that snow would compress into ice sheets. These glaciers would start in places like the northmost regions of Canada and Russia, and they would spread from there. The ice would mostly form on dry land. That's because the water surrounding the ice would create a barrier, preventing it from expanding as easily. Today, about 10% of Earth's land surface is covered by ice. As our new ice age progresses, you could see go up to about 25%. Ice would cover Eurasia from the British Isles to Siberia. Himalayan ice sheets would spawn through Asia. And while the southern hemisphere wouldn't be as icy, an ice sheet would run from the southern tip of Patagonia well into the Andes of mountains. But ice wouldn't be the only change. Sea levels could drop out about 120 meters lower than they are right now. This could close off the Mediterranean Sea to the Atlantic Ocean without anywhere else to go. Rainfall and glacier melting would feed bodies of water in regions that are not frozen over. Some rivers would also change their usual runoff and form new lakes. With all these things in sea levels around the world, land bridges would reemerge. Russia would now be connected to Alaska, and the islands of Indonesia would be connected to mainland Southeast Asia. The borders would change and bring various countries closer together, or it would result in whole new countries begin form, opening up new land for you to migrate to, and you would need to. Regions that you and hundreds of millions of other people used to call home would be essentially uninhabitable. Surviving the cold mean moving away from the iciest part, North America and Eurasia, but the rest of the world wouldn't be too welcoming either. It would get really dry, deserts would spawn, so the remaining tropical forest near the equator would be refuge for the most of the planet's plant and animal life. But what about us? Well, during the most recent ice age, we actually developed as a species. The land bridges allowed us to spread out across the globe, and the climate forced us to adapt new tools and clothing. And as Earth rewarmed, we started farming. It's likely that we would not fare as well with a new ice age, not right at least. Almost all of the agricultural land would be lost, so intense overcrowding in the hospital regions would create chaos. We should get ready for extreme competition for the life basic necessities. But I do have a good news for you. Based on the current climate science and the amount of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere, we may have postponed the next possible ice age by about 500,000 years. And if we keep pumping out greenhouse gases, it's possible that we have not only postponed it, but we have made it impossible. That just means we all overheat, which I guess better than being frozen. So Earth freezing over May, not something you would need to be worried about. But what about the next solar storm that is coming to hit us? For such amazing videos, keep watching. Just imagine.